So this is it, my final accountability as MDHSU president. I'm sure you're already sick of hearing my voice by now, but as always, I'm going to take the opportunity to talk a little bit more. Unfortunately, I've been very busy these last few months with various events, NUS National Conference, and the MDHSU elections, but I have a few updates that you're all going to have to sit through. Firstly, I want to talk about the Community Placement Scheme. We're at the end of an amazing second year of the scheme. Here at MDHSU, we've had the opportunity to pay £40,000 to students who are on placement, who have committed near to 3,500 hours of their time to helping the local community. This year, we had over 260 applications from students in Middlesex, and I'm currently in the process of securing funding to guarantee its continuation and keep providing paid work-based experience to students while benefiting the local community. Last week, we held our fifth annual Student-Led Teaching Awards. It was a fantastic night where Raquel and I had the pleasure of recognising and awarding members of university staff who have made a genuine difference to students' lives at Middlesex University. These awards are incredibly important and are a true reflection of the strong partnership held between MDHSU and the university, which we must uphold to continue making a positive impact on your experience as students. And now, what is even more exciting is the upcoming MDHSU Awards. Here we get to hear all about the year's best events, best societies, and most amazing students. There are 8 awards up for grabs, with all shortlisted students and societies being invited to the awards night in central London on the 10th of May. The deadline to place nominations is on Wednesday, the 18th of April, so only 2 days away from this AGM, so please, please, please get your nominations in if you haven't already. As I've mentioned previously, I was lucky enough to be elected NUS delegate, so I made the trip to NUS National Conference 2018 in Glasgow at the end of March. It was extremely exciting and an absolute pleasure to represent you by voting on policy and voting in the elections for the next set of NUS full-time officers. I'm unsure if any of you have heard about the controversy that surrounded this year's National Conference, but irrespective of protests, occupations and disagreements, it is so important to remember that as a student body we remain united and ensure we get the best out of our affiliation to the National Union of Students. I will continue to do my best to do what's best for MDHSU and its membership as I've done all year, and as always I'm happy to answer any queries and ease any concerns that any of you may have. Last but by no means least, I want to talk about Summer Shutdown. This year it's on Wednesday the 16th of May, 7pm till 3am, featuring a fairground ride, a food court, silent disco, DJs until 3am, live music and performances, and much more to be announced. Super early bird tickets have already sold out, but there are early bird tickets still available for £10, which include a free drink. I've listened to students and I've made sure the ticket prices are more affordable this year for all of you to enjoy and celebrate the end of exams and start your summer with a bang. So, get online and get your cheaper tickets now to ensure that you can come to our best event, Summer Shutdown. Now, you'll all be very glad to hear that that was the conclusion to my accountability, and as promised, I'm sure you're all extremely bored of hearing my voice. I just wanted to take this last opportunity to say that I'm not finished yet, and I'm always here to listen to your ideas, learn from them, and ultimately lead this amazing student union. Thank you so much for listening to my final accountability.